film always was, why it was not getting made for a long time, was it's a story of the city. When you make a film like that, then you have to create a city without it.
आपके हिसाब से फॉकलैंड रोड का फ्रंट ऐसा दिखता है?
ये ऐसा ही दिखता
है। ऐसा ही शूट करेंगे।
Every time the question came up of where do we shoot this, let's just make the whole film on a set.
हम मतलब I'm saying suppose ये वॉल इधर है ना, बालकनी ये यही बालकनी, यहाँ से यहाँ तक।
We were looking for a place where we could actually, we wanted to build this huge massive set and couldn't find any place in India that let us build a set and the streets and everything and all the associated stuff outside of it.
We traveled till Vivek Agarwal actually came across this whole Sri Lankan thing and he said, you know, let's go visit Sri Lanka. I said, what will happen in Sri Lanka? He says, they want to revive the film culture there. They have this land where they want to build a studio.
We just through our locations team, we had done an extensive search in Sri Lanka, but nobody was considering it seriously. The production and the location team suggested that why don't we also explore Sri Lanka based on the pictures that came to us.
On the land that was to be built into a studio, we actually, with the government of Sri Lanka, built it from the scratch.
The road, वो सब जो है ना, वहाँ पे भी कुछ बना। ये बॉम्बे रोड अभी घूम गया है।
अभी घूम गया, मैं हमी घुमा दूँगा।
We are going to mark out the city, Bombay Velvet Club, and the streets.
With a lot of local people, there's a local art director from Colombo who kind of we worked with.
This has to be on zero level. So we'll start doing the marking and we'll put up, start putting up building, and wherever they need more land leveling, they'll do it.
And with his expertise and Sonal Savant, who's I think one of the finest production designers. She's meticulous to the point and detailed to the point of, I don't know, her perfection is to the point of fault.
Just to try and execute the whole film in Sri Lanka was a task by itself, because we were working with a really efficient and a hard-working crew, but just the work pattern was completely different. We didn't speak the language, they didn't speak English either.
How is the work going here? How is the work going on here?
The kind of experience and the support that I had from my own crew, as well as the Sri Lankan crew, as well as our production team, was quite special.
Stages of how, from flat land, how we had to extend the land, cover kind of a stream and extend the area. It went on for about 8 or 9 months.
Every time we used to close to finish, we thought that we are almost there, and we were not there. 2 days later, we were back to square one. So it was a consistent exercise that used to go on. If something came right, there were 2 things that went wrong. So yeah, the club was something else. It took something else out of us by the end of it, because we tried, we kept on at it like mad people. Yeah.
The first time I went on set in Sri Lanka, I was just like shocked, because it was like being in Universal Studios or something, you know. It's like I've never worked at such a high like scale, like the way this film is. It's just like spread out completely. And then the main, like Bombay Velvet, the club, it's majestic.
The scale of Bombay Velvet is the believability of Bombay in 1960s, 1950s. And I think if we are able to achieve that, then we have really achieved the scale of the film.
set was like a real, like a full new city. You know, it was just amazing.
It's not just that scale is humongous, it's all just so well done. If you look at the aerial shots of the set, it's spectacular. It's unbelievable, actually.
महाबात पूरी बीमारी लगी तुझे